Hello and welcome to Newsclick. Today we have with us Bappa Sinha, who's part of the Free Software Movement of India and also has been studying the Aadhaar issue for quite some time. Bappa, a lot of people have raised issues of privacy, but there has been concerns, which you have also raised, regarding security issues that affect not only the individual, also for the banking system. Now, we recently had the case of the Aadhaar app, for instance. The M-Aadhaar, as it is called, which is very easily broken into by anybody. Issues have also been that various Aadhaar card numbers have been linked to phone numbers without actually the original Aadhaar holder even knowing about it. Now, what does this indicate? Do you think that basically the whole issue boils down to the fact that originally Aadhaar was supposed to be a biometric system? Now, the Aadhaar card, the Aadhaar numbers, the M-Aadhaar, all being used as identity proofs, which was not the original intent?
Right. So, initially when Aadhaar was formulated, the idea was that you could provide your Aadhaar number to somebody and using your biometrics, you would get verified. So, that's a proof of identity for digitally you get identified. And so you could go to a store or you could go to a bank, and in order to prove who you are, your number along with your fingerprint or your iris scan would be sufficient to
uniquely identify you.
And it was not, Aadhaar is not meant to be used as your ID card, right? It's not your driver license where the physical card is a proof that you are who you claim to be. It was meant for a digital verification. But what we have seen is that it is being used widely, both by the government and by private companies, with the encouragement of government, where it has been used as a identity card, where people are taking photocopies of your Aadhaar card. If you go to an airport, flashing your Aadhaar card, people would then say that because you're carrying your Aadhaar card, that proves that you are who you are. But Aadhaar was not meant to be that system. And that, using Aadhaar in that fashion is problematic.
Why is it problematic? Now, one of the issues, of course, is that government is saying any printout of the Aadhaar is equivalent to the original Aadhaar. There is no concept in that sense of an original Aadhaar. It's also saying the M-Aadhaar, what you can download on your mobile, is equivalent to your Aadhaar ID. Now, essentially, these are multiple IDs or the same ID copied multiple times. Why does it create a security problem?
Yeah, so there were two things. One is your physical possession and as well as the security features which are introduced to further enhance the security. But for example, if you lose your passport or you lose your driver license, then you're immediately supposed to contact government authorities because there has been a breach. Aadhaar, so the government has taken different positions at different points in time about Aadhaar, right? So Aadhaar, because if you know your Aadhaar number and using, anybody can log into the UIDAI site and get a printout of your Aadhaar card. And the government at one point is saying that is sufficient. Now, if that is sufficient, that means that the physical possession of the Aadhaar card does not prove that you are who you claim to be. But at the same time, that has been widely used at different places
to establish your identity,
right? Now, why that is problematic is that these ID cards, if you can print multiple copies of the ID cards, then if somebody else could, if you lose your ID card, somebody else can take that ID card and then claim to be you.
No, you don't have to lose your ID card. Somebody, as you said, could print out the ID by just getting your ID number. And as long as your Aadhaar number is known, and we'll come to that in a minute, as long as your ID number, Aadhaar ID is known, the number is known, they can print out a copy of it, as you said.
Yeah.
So therefore, you don't even have to lose it. Officially, any copy is a valid copy according to the government.
Yeah. Through different mechanisms, when you go to the government's UIDAI site, you have to give your Aadhaar number and some other form of identification, right? So be it biometrics or a OTP, but if somebody were to have access to that, they can take a printout of the card and then claim to be you because they physically are producing that card, and that is acceptable in many places.
You know, when you link your Aadhaar number to, for instance, your phone or to your bank account, then even these procedures are not followed. You just give the Aadhaar number and that gets linked to your phone numbers and so on. Secondly, it seems to be very easy to do if you're within the system. So do you see that as also a problem that, for instance, a criminal might use mine or your Aadhaar number if it is available in the public domain and link it to criminal activities using their phones or their bank accounts?
Oh, yeah. So if you are, and the Aadhaar ecosystem is so wide, it is not restricted to a few certified government agencies, but the government has contracted and encouraged it has contracted with certain private entities, and then it has encouraged a whole ecosystem of people to play, to be enrollment agents, to be taking your biometrics. And if any of these, I think the estimates are there are more than a few lakhs of these people, and if any of these people were to want to criminally impersonate you, then it's very easy for them. If you go to a Airtel shop and give your fingerprint, and the person who is taking the fingerprint wants to steal your ID, then it's relatively trivial for that person.
That, of course, is with the biometric. I'm only talking about, even if they don't have your fingerprints, they can use the Aadhaar number and link it to various bank accounts and, for instance, phone numbers. In fact, there are multiple examples of this happening. Yeah. And we have enough examples in the press, the recent times, which shows that phone numbers of people have been linked to Aadhaar cards without the people who have the Aadhaar number being even aware of it. So this obviously seems to be an easy thing to do. We have had cases where somebody who was from a Pakistani agent who was deported back to Pakistan, he had an Aadhaar number, and that was linked to various subsidies and bank accounts and telephone numbers and so on.
Gas subsidies, bank accounts.
Yeah. Which showed that apparently the Aadhaar number of a person can be easily linked to these things, yeah, without the biometrics being used. And the original act, if you remember, the original act didn't really envisage this. The original act considers biometrics to be the basis of verification. It never thought that, it was never envisaged within the act. It really doesn't envisage the use of the Aadhaar card as the proof of ID, which it seems to now have become.
Yeah, sure. I think in a country like India, right, where it's a vast country, and in many places you have either no or intermittent electricity and internet connection, I think it started off in those places where, since in order to do your biometric verification, you have to go all the way back to the central CIDR to get it verified. And if you have intermittent or no internet connectivity, then you can't do that, right? So then what people would do, and this is not in rural areas, even if you go to posh areas in Delhi and want to do an Aadhaar verification, they will say that, okay, we are going to take a photocopy of your Aadhaar, we are going to take your biometrics, and we will upload it the next day. So there is a period of time when they are holding on to that data, and then if somebody wants, they can easily make a copy of the data and do whatever they want to do with that data.
You know, the argument about this issue is also that, for instance, something like 250 million Aadhaar numbers are already in public domain because government posted them on many occasions. And this was pointed out by the Center for Internet Studies, after which the government filed an FIR against them. It's always shooting the messenger model, as it were. And net consequences of this is that though it might have gone off the news, the reality is there is a huge number of other numbers which are out in public domain. You yourself have done a small study which shows a lot of the EKIC people hold the data on open form on computers where the IP addresses are available and anybody can log into that. This doesn't involve hacking, and they have completely unsecured against any such intrusion. So if so much of Aadhaar numbers are in public domain, no criminal then will use his own Aadhaar number for bank accounts and for phones, but it's going to link all these open numbers to such activities. So isn't it Isn't the government even thinking about this? What do you think is happening?
So the government seems to be in complete denial mode. Like you said, the standard response of the government is to say, to file FIRs against the whistleblowers, against the people who point out security holes. And the other thing to say, the biometrics has not been breached, right? That is the standard response. But some of these, what has happened, what these different stories have shown is that the leaks are widespread and they could be easily used for any amount of criminal activities, right? The other thing is that where people are taking, like in all these internet sites, people are taking photocopies and keeping Aadhaar, PAN, bank information together openly, right? There is no even attempt. And forget about the e-kendras and the private side, but the CIA study showed that government departments were doing this.
So the government departments to various other people are keeping all of this openly. So this is essentially an issue where the original intent of Aadhaar, which is biometric verification, has given away to a verification using the Aadhaar card or the Aadhaar number or Aadhaar as it is being called. In effect, it is a complete change of tack from the original intent. And as you said, it seems to have happened because of convenience, that it is more difficult to do verification in real time, particularly with intermittent connectivity, intermittent electricity, and so on. So the financial system cannot really work on this basis. And therefore, this convenience is what has created a big security hole in the Aadhaar system. This is what I understand you are saying. But my question is, can the Aadhaar system now be actually saved, given the fact that it is being used in this particular way? Can the Aadhaar system actually be saved? Or if it has to work, it has got to go back to biometric verification and live with the problem that you have intermittent connectivity and intermittent electricity?
So there are multiple questions to that, right? Now, the known leaks, right, and the CIS leak was one of the biggest ones. So like you said, there are roughly a quarter of a billion people who are probably, we know that their Aadhaar has been linked, leaked. So that is like 20% of the population of the country. Then the Tribune report, that showed that effectively people were given access to a website where you could enter any Aadhaar number and get that information.
For all the billion people.
And different estimates say that there was a period of months where that access was available till Tribune broke the story and they withdrew the access. So if you go by the Aadhaar, the Aadhaar number, and the certain digits which are coded for the sanctity of the number, if you remove those, there are roughly 80 billion such numbers. Now, for a computer program to scan over 80 billion numbers in a time period of months is trivial. For all we know, that all numbers, not just quarter of a billion numbers, but all numbers have already been leaked, and that information is already available to people. At this point, then what can be done to save the system? Our personal information is no longer personal; it's all now in public. But in order to save the system, not only one is that you go back to only using it as biometrics, but there has to be some additional security on top of biometrics. A password, a PIN code which you could change, and that at the very least has to be done. But the whole intent of Aadhaar was to get away from doing that, right? So then the whole point of Aadhaar is lost. The government seems to be hell-bent on like defending the indefensible, but at this point, it seems difficult to salvage this thing.
At the very least, linking Aadhaar to all things, including getting a haircut, including getting a beard trim, from banks to phone numbers, all of this should stop, because these are really opening the way for only criminals to misuse the system, and it doesn't do any good to anybody. What else? What How are you going to find people if you have such a gaping hole in the system? Anybody can use it in a different way.
And if you link it to things like your mobile system, right? Your telecom system, and you link it to your banking system. If you think about it, and given that all this information has now become public, you are opening yourself up, not individuals, but you're opening the country up to cyber attacks. I mean, there have been cases elsewhere in the world, right? We know, for example, critical Iranian installations were cyber attacked by US intelligence agencies. Those stories have been there. Now what you're doing is you are not only opening yourself up to cyber attacks from other states, you are opening up yourself up to cyber attacks from rogue elements, right? From terrorists, right? Now it's curious that a government which claims to be a nationalist government is giving away your country's security to terrorist elements.
And shooting the messenger, the last question. There is a French security expert who showed how the M Aadhaar app was faulty, the number of holes in it. It seems that some UIDAI has done something with regard to that. What have they done?
So it has now become a joke. So there is this French security expert who goes by the name of Elliot Alderson, and he has been posting on Twitter. And so he was scrutinizing the M Aadhaar app, and he found just elementary mistakes. What he called the level of the Aadhaar the app was at the level of a school project, and he found the Aadhaar app was actually not signed by Aadhaar or the company which UIDAI had contracted it to, but it was being signed by Google. So what it means is when something is signed by Google's known signature, that means anybody can create another app which doesn't do what it's advertised to do, but steals your information or makes bank transfers in your name, and you wouldn't know because their app is signed by Google. And the passwords they were using were sample passwords which Google had given in its code. So you are supposed to take those passwords and then create your own passwords, but they hadn't bothered to do that. As a result, it was trivial to hack the M Aadhaar app. So according to his tweets, if you lost your cell phone and you had M Aadhaar on that and you had logged into that app, then you can assume that your Aadhaar is compromised and your bank accounts are compromised. So he had pointed all this to UIDAI and
asked them to fix the problem.
Well, he was sarcastic about it, but he did ask them to fix the problem. And initially, the initial response from the government was to pull the apps. It now seems
pull
that,
the app down.
Yeah, sorry. So take down the apps from the Google App Store. But it now seems that they have put it back up, and without fixing the problems, and they have just restricted the viewership of the app to India. And so our French security expert is not able to access the app sitting in France. Of course, it is trivial to bypass that. But so what we are effectively looking at is the level of technical sophistication of the people who are responding to these whistleblowers and to this public who are pointing out flaws seems to be extremely low. Their technical competence they seem singularly incompetent in dealing with an app of this complexity.
They believe that the problem will go away if you shut your eyes to it, or you shoot the person who's telling us that there is a problem.
So Nandan Nilekani, he said that it's an evolving system. So it is understood in these things that you come up with any piece of technology, that you improve technology over time. But you don't come up with a schoolboy project and impose it on the population of the country and on the banking system of the country, and then say that we are going to evolve.
Anyway, we seem to be evolving backwards, going from school project to primary school project. Thank you very much, Bappa, to be with us. This is all the time we have for NewsClick today. Do keep watching NewsClick.